The hadith says, anyone who visits me in my ghurbat, in my strangehood, recognizing my status, I will also visit him in his qabr. The same number of times he comes to visit me, I will come to visit him. That's why one of our ulama, he goes to the ziyarah of Imam al-Rida alayhi salam, and he says, Yabna Rasulullah, I don't have any hajah. I don't want to ask for anything except that you fulfill the promise. You say that if we come to visit you, you'll come. I need that. That's all I want. I don't want anything for my dunya. This is all I want from you. He is gharib al-ghuraba. And we will be one day gharib in our grave, strangers in our grave. That's why we need his help. We need their shafa'ah. We cannot make it without their shafa'ah. When the news reached that he must leave Medina, it was his last day in Medina. He was forced to leave it. He could not stay. He had no choice. It is said he went to the qabr of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. He sat on the qabr of Rasulullah the whole night, crying, weeping. He says, Ya Jaddah, Ya Rasulullah, I'm being forced to leave you. I don't want to leave this place, but I have no choice. I have to go. Some parts of the night he gets up. He wants to go back home. He couldn't. He comes back to the grave, sits again, continues to weep. He gets up a second time. He couldn't. He comes back. Then the third time he is forced. He goes back home. It is said he gathered his family members. He gathered the family members. And he said, let's do a majlis of aza. He said, for who, Ibn Rasulullah? He said, for me. Imam al-Rida alayhi salam, in his lifetime, orders his family members to do majlis al-aza for him. Just like you are participating, brothers and sisters, tonight. Inshallah, Allah accept this majlis from us as a humble gift to the Imam salamullahi alayhi. He says, have a majlis of aza for me. Why, Ibn Rasulullah? Because when I leave, I'm not coming back again. I'm going to die gharib in Khurasa. So have a majlis of aza. They held a majlis of aza, ma'atam, for the Imam in his life. He was present there. They cried, they wept. And then he was taken to Khurasan, where he only stayed for 2 years until Ma'mun's hatred grew so much that he himself poisoned the grapes or the pomegranates with his own hands and fed them to Imam al-Rida salamullahi alayhi. Look at how evil this man was. Himself, he poisoned it, and he feeds it. Imam al-Rida salamullahi alayhi, who again submits to Allah. This is what Allah's order is, for him to have that poison. His time is finished. So he submits to Allah and to the command of Allah. He eats a few of these grapes or pomegranates. Ma'mun says, eat more. He says, this is enough to execute your plot. This is enough. Your plan will now be executed. Khalas. He goes back home. He starts suffering from the pain of the poison. Starts hurting him. On his last day, it is narrated, he looked around his servants. He said to them, have you eaten today? On his last day. They said to him, Ya Ibn Rasulullah, and who has the appetite to eat when you're in such a state? He says, that's not right. He gets up. He says, bring the table. Bring the food. Despite his pain, he sits with them. He says, have another table for the ladies. They bring the other table. He sits with them. He eats with them. Despite his pain, That's why one of the titles of this Imam is al-Imamur Ra'uf, the compassionate Imam. Even through his pain, through his difficulty, he worries about his servants. He worries about his slaves. He worries that you have not eaten. So he sits down and eats with them. I say, Ya Ibn Rasulillah, we are also your servants. We hope to consider us as your servants. And your ra'fa, your compassion to accommodate us as well. Then when the pain gets stronger on him, he tells one of his companions by the name of Abu Salt, Abu Salt, let's go to my room. He goes inside his room. He says, Ya Abu Salt, lock the doors and don't let anyone to enter, for this is my final moments. Abu Salt says, I closed the doors. I was alone with the Imam Salamullahi Alayhi in the room, looking at him in his final moments, bearing the pain of the poison, difficulties. At that moment, I saw a young boy entering the room. I looked at him and I said, who are you and how did you enter here? I've locked these gates. He looked at me and said, Ya Abu Salt, the one who brought me from Medina is the one who allowed me to enter these closed gates. Who are you? I am Muhammad ibn Ali al-Jawayad. He comes, he throws himself on the body of his father, Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam. Imam al-Ridha opens his eyes in his final moments. He sees his son on his chest. He hugs him, he kisses him. He gives him his wasiyah, his final will. And then he stretches his arms and feet and he says, Bismillah wa billah wa ala millati jaddi Rasulillah. And his soul leaves his body. Imam al-Jawad cries, Aywa abata, aywa mazluma, aywa shahida, aywa ghariba. And he takes care of the ghusl and the kafan and the burial of his father. With no one realizing it, his Imam Salamullah alayhi Abu Sal says, I see the Imam doing the ghusl and the kafan, and the others think that they are doing the ghusl and the kafan. But it is the Imam, I see him. And he buries his father, Imam al-Ridha Gharib in Khurasan. I say, Ya Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam, you opened your eyes, you saw your son al-Jawad on your chest. At that point, did you remember your grandfather Abi Abdullah al-Husayn? He threw himself on the chest of Ali al-Akbar. He saw the body of his son cut into pieces and in front of his eyes. He saw him with a chest with the spear in his chest. He threw himself on the chest of Ali al-Akbar crying, Waladi Ali, على الدنيا بعدك العفايا. Oh my son, I wish I had not lived to see this moment. Oh Imam al-Ridha, your son Muhammad al-Jawad alayhi salam took care of your burial and your ghusl and kafan, but there was no one for Abi Abdullah al-Husayn al-Karbala. 3 days lying on the plains of Karbala with Zainab looking at his body crying, Aywa Jadda wa Muhammada, this is your Hussein in Karbala, Ya Jadda, who will bury him? Inna lillah
wa inna ilayhi raji'un wa sayalamu alladhina zalamu ayya munqalabin yanqalibun wal aqibatu lil muttaqin.